By the way, for Kelly Rempel from Jeff Michaels writing in, he says, FYI, Little Arrows is from Leapy Lee in 1968. Is that a real
Steven
song?
Steven Numedal, he chimed in. People are just, like, that's the thing about shows like this. If you don't
bringing
have an answer,
together.
It brings, sure, it brings people together.
Yeah.
Who would have thought that the Leapy Lee hit Little Arrows would fill the board up?
I know.
Oh, man. I see you're sporting a Moose Jaw Warriors.
It was a gift.
Shirt today.
It was a gift from the Warriors who brought me into their souvenir store and said, help yourself, which was awesome. And I do have done a lot of work with them. Love them. And yeah, I'm a, obviously, you know, a big junior hockey fan. But to the CFL, and I don't even know why I would talk about this. I will get your opinion, Remps, on the Zach Collaros deal. There was a lot of conjecture and all the rest going into the trade deadline. What was going to happen? What wasn't? And actually, the what is it? Not Rod Black Twitter account? The parody of Rod Black? Have you seen this? So funny, because he said from the Not Rod Black account, I love CFL trade deadline time, the rumors, the gossip, the conjecture. Now all we need is trades.
All we need is something to actually happen.
The same thing. And there was all this talk about Collaros going to Winnipeg. Now, John Lynch coined the phrase, where there's smoke, there's fire. So it looked like Collaros was going to go to Winnipeg. And I still don't, I see people saying this is a, he can be an impact player. This is what the Bombers need. I've said it a million times. He hasn't been able to get onto the field. He hasn't thrown a pass in a game in a year. It's a nothing trade to me. There are others that feel otherwise, and that's going to happen. But Kelly, where are you on that deal? And then we'll swing over to you, Dupes.
I look at it and say, you know, what's the downside for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers to go out and acquire Zach Collaros? And there isn't one. So it's in my mind, fairly insignificant, because if they get to the point where they need to bring him on the field to make, you know, to play, they're in big trouble. But they obviously have zero confidence in whoever's behind, you know, the young quarterbacks that are playing behind Streveler. So what do they really have to lose? I mean, the guy's sitting there in Toronto not doing anything. He gives the experience. Maybe they feel that, you know, he's going to be able to help a young quarterback along. I think Zach does know the game pretty well and understand the game. So I think that they're probably even thinking like he could almost be like another coach and mentor for the kid. But if it has to be where he has to actually physically come out on the field, they probably feel like, even if they had a 1 in 100 chance of winning a game without, you know, Streveler, Collaros is going to give them a 5 out of 100 chance. It's better than what we had before, because they obviously have no confidence in their current support group. So really, what do they have to lose?
I mean, that's a good point.
Money. That's it. It's going to cost you some money
and a third round pick.
Yeah. But you know, they're in full-on survival mode. I mean, what have they scored? Haven't scored a touchdown in 11 quarters or 10 and a half quarters or something? Like, so really, what do you have to lose? Nothing.
No, you don't. But here's the question of the day, the $64,000 question. Do you at any point see Zach Collaros starting a game?
No.
I do. I don't think he's going to start.
He's not going
to
start.
I don't think he's brought in to start. I don't think he was traded to start for Winnipeg. I think this is Chris Streveler's team. I really do. But I've said this the whole time, and I've never wavered, that Zach's the guy they needed to go after of anybody in Toronto. And clearly, they've been after him the whole time. Not that they're listening to this program, but I think it's a good move, because of the three quarterbacks or any of the quarterbacks available, Zach Collaros has the lowest floor when he's healthy and when he's playing. Now, I don't think he's the most durable, and do I think that the first hit he takes, it might be the last one? Yeah, I do. But if you're going to be a Grey Cup contender and if you're going to take that shot, why not make sure you're the most prepared to compete should something happen? Now, if Chris Streveler goes down, or you decide he just can't get it done, well, you've got Collaros. But if you don't, you don't really have an opportunity. He gives you the best chance to win if he's healthy. Now, if he goes down too, well, then you're out. But at least you've taken that chance. And at least you put yourself in a position to have a chance to win. And I think that's the most important thing. I don't think people in Winnipeg should be excited that he's going to start, but be excited that if Streveler goes down, your season's not completely over.
Well, There's a lot of people that agree with you. As a matter of fact, Nelson from Phoenix writing in, and it's scrolled off the page here, but it was something. He said the exact same thing. That if Strev goes down, here it is. The downside is Zach's health. If Strev goes down and Zach goes down, 1990 continues to be the best year in Winnipeg. Well, when Matt Nichols went down, that is when the drought continued, in my mind.
Yeah.
They haven't been able to win with Strebler.
Right.
And I...
But if there's a guy...
It's not about whether they can win or not with Zach. It's can Zach stay upright?
Yeah.
And Rams, that's where you and I agree on this.
Yeah. And I remember sitting in this chair. Well, it might have been that chair. I can't remember. At the beginning of the year. And the one thing that I said when he was with the Riders is I just said, how many hits is this guy going to be able to take before we don't see him again? Like... My thinking at that time was, I think we need to move on from this guy. I'm shocked that they were willing to bring him back, pay him a decent salary, because he's one hit away from you're not going to see him for weeks and weeks and weeks. And when are we going to stop trying to convince ourselves that, well, maybe this time. No, it's done. It's over for this guy. And what was it? Third play of the game.
Yep.
First hit that he took. Now, it was a dirty, cheap shot. I'll give you that. And a lot of guys would have went down for the count after that hit.
Yep.
So I'm not blaming him for that. I give him credit. It's like Buck Pierce. I always said Buck Pierce is a warrior. He's a tough guy. But at some point in your career, when it's obvious that your body just can't absorb the physicalness of a violent game like football, you should probably just quit. Move on with your life. Move on with your career. Is it really worth it? But you can't tell these guys that
No.
because they've got something inside them that still thinks that they can play. But, you know, I don't know. I just, the first hard shot that he takes, he's done.
I know. But for right now, we're past that. Because we're not in decision
until
time.
Until he gets on the field again.
But we're not in decision time for Zach Collaros. He's already made his decision that he wants to play football. The football teams have made the decision.
But Kelly's saying one hit with the Bombers, and it's right back where they were.
You know what? And I don't disagree with that, right? But he's going to play. He's going to be on the roster. He's going to dress. He wants to play.
He's going to be on the roster.
He's not done.
There's a big difference between being on the roster and playing.
But there's enough playmakers, too, on that offense. And with Andrew Harris there, too. Paul LaPolice says his work cut out for him, too, if Zach ever gets in. Make sure you keep him healthy. And maybe that's what they're thinking in Winnipeg. Hey, we got to get him the ball. We have to get him to get rid of the ball really quickly. And guys, he can't get hit. Period.
They don't never want a quarterback.
Period. The Riders told their offensive line that, too, and it didn't help.
I know.
Because the first time he got hit.
But he ran. He ran and took that hit. And he was sliding and he took that hit.
Yeah.
Like, you can't even do that. Right?
Do we have the Grim Reaper ready, Clark? Oh, just settling into his chair, Clark tells me. The Grim Reaper, Nashville Predators broadcast, longtime NHL alum and Regina Pats alum, I might add. Stu Grimson will be joining us from Nashville in moments. There is news out of Calgary today, and it has to do with the Stampeders roster. Derek Dennis, star left tackle, will not play Friday night, nor will Jamar Wall. So I saw that on Twitter, and also Nelson writing in with that information this morning. So certainly a boon for the Rough Riders going into Calgary and what we believe will be voted as Canada's game of the week in the CFL here, week 18.
You're watching Rod Pedersen On Demand. For more of the Rod Pedersen Show, visit rodpedersen.com or follow Rod Pedersen on social media.